have some Corellas here this morning. The one on the left's a baby. Mum's just regurgitating food, and there you go, feeding it to baby. Pretty cool, hey? Babies are quite loud. She's regurgitating again, there she goes. And into baby's mouth. Yes, you're very loud, aren't you, asking for food. I had one YouTuber saying, why don't you feed the baby? Why do you let it cry like that? It's a wild bird. It's not up to me to feed it. The mother's regurgitating there. Oh, she needs some more seed. It's not up to me to feed it. These birds stay with their parents for about a year and they're fed. I can't physically feed the baby bird. It needs to come from its parents. So that people understand. Cute little thing though, isn't it? It's very loud. Feed me, feed me. You're going to ask your dad now, are you? He's busy eating. He'll feed you in a minute when he's ready. Alright. Let dad eat for a bit and then he'll feed you. Right, on to pouring. G'day guys, welcome back. Yesterday I trialled a new brand of paint. It was called Ireldo di Paola. Ireldo for short. I'll show you the results. If you missed that video, I'll show you the results. I'm going to go again with exactly the same colours, the prime colours, with white, but in global. And we'll just see what the difference is, hey? So I had cool red, cool yellow, green light, cool blue, and white. So in the global, same, white, light green, cool blue, cool yellow, red. So exactly the same colors, exactly the same pouring medium, 70% glue, 30% water. With the Ireldo, I had to thicken the paint up because it's quite thin. I had to use 1.5 parts paint to 1 part pouring medium. With the global, I'm just doing 1:1. It's a thicker paint. So 1 part paint, 1 part pouring medium. So I've got 50 grams of pouring medium, 50 grams of paint. And I'm going to layer them. I'll just show you the previous result. The colours were really nice and bright when I tipped the cup over. But as I started to tilt, I noticed that they were blurring. Very, very cell reactive, but not the best shaped cells that I've had. Some of the paint did split. You can see there the red and the blue. Split some pretty cells, but overall wasn't that happy with it. So I'm going to go exactly the same colors as I said with the global and just see what the difference is, if there's any difference. Maybe it's just those colors that don't react well, so we'll give it a go, right? There's my cup. Got my card today. It's a 950 gram weight. There's a link for it for eBay and Amazon in the Australian Acrylic Pouring Group in the files section. Treadmill silicone, that's what I want, by Spot On. I'm going to do 3 drops in each except for the white. Nice bright colours these, eh? Although you do have to be careful if you're using primaries where you put them. There's a huge chance of getting mud. Because these two make brown, these two make purple. So I've put my blue next to my white, so that's a light blue. The blue and the green next to each other, that'll make a turquoise. The green and the yellow will just make a lime. The yellow and the red will obviously make orange. And then I go back for my next layer, red and white will make pink. So when they all mix in the cup, yes, I'm gonna get some brown. I'm going to get some purple. it's not the best color scheme to use. You know, try a complementary color, especially if you're starting out. Do blues and greens together, or blues and turquoises together, or blue, green and turquoise. Don't do what I'm doing. It just doesn't work. 9 times out of 10, it doesn't work. So stick to complementary colors. There's more white. I'll try for 3 layers. Blue. Well, the green feels a little bit thinner. The green and the red seem to be a little bit thinner when they came out of the jar. The yellow was a bit thicker. I just had to add a splash of water to the yellow. And as usual, I add, when I'm doing my white, I always do 10 grams less of the white paint, because the white's always a thicker paint for some reason. So I did 60 grams of pouring medium and 50 grams of white. So yes, it looks as if I'll do 3 layers. Don't make your layers too thin, otherwise your colors tend to blend more and you just don't see the definition of your colors if your layers are too thin. So have a good layer of each color. That way you can hopefully see the actual color in the pour and it's not just all blended together. Because I've got that extra 10 grams of white, I'll probably have enough just to pop over the top of my last layer. So this is a 30 by 40 centimeter thick card, box board, chipboard. It's not a timber, it's a cardboard. It's a recycled cardboard. Hopefully you can find it. It's on Amazon, it's on eBay. This is an A3 size. And I know for this size I need about 500 grams of mixed paint. Nice big full cup. With different techniques, you don't need as much paint. Like with, if I'm doing a swipe, I don't need as much paint because the swipe mix is also thinner. So because it's thinner, it spreads more. So you don't need as much to cover the whole surface. But the flip cup pours, I like the mix to be really quite thick so it holds the cells in shape. If you have a really thin mix, the cells are just going to go all wobbly and out of shape. So you need to thicken it up to keep that beautiful round cell shape. Finish off with a little bit of white. Not much left, but a little bit. Keen to see what these are going to do actually after that experiment yesterday with the Areldos. I'm not here to pick on any brand of paint. I just want to trial different paints with my pouring medium. Not all paints work with my pouring medium, and that's, you know, that doesn't mean that it's not a good paint. It just means that for me, with my pouring medium, it doesn't give me the results I want. But by all means, it doesn't mean that, you know, those paints aren't good paints. I've tried my pouring medium with Global, Areldo, Montmartre, Liquitex Basics, Chroma, Deco Art, lots of different brands. And I find that the Global works best for me with my pouring medium. But if, you know, if you're using those other brands, you may be using a different pouring medium, or you're using Floetrol, Bort pouring medium, Liquitex pouring medium, whatever you want to use. Find something that works for you and stick to it. That's what I say. Righto, let's do this. Oh no, my cup dripped. I hate it when that happens. Look at those colours. I always get this on the side. I don't know why. Do I want to use that extra paint? No, I don't. Because it's gone a bit muddy in there. There's a tiny bit left in the bottom, about that much, but it's really not worth using it. I've got enough here to coat everything. If you go around putting paint on the corners, you're going to tip it off anyway. just going to move this around a little bit just so that I don't have to stretch my cells too much once I've torched. Okay, let's get the torch out. It's bizarre how I've just got this red band there with the colours on the side, isn't it? Hopefully there's some colours under that red. I'm getting a rainbow effect. I've got the red, the orange, the green, the blue, the purple. As we go down the canvas, I've got all these different shades in my background. The torching, torching. Probably have to tip some of that red off. It's a bit much. It's a bit overpowering, isn't it? I don't know why I've got that big block of red there. I layered everything exactly the same amounts. Try and figure out a different way of flipping my cups over so that I don't get that. So torching, torching, torching. I can see straight away that with the global I can torch much longer without, you know, too many cells coming up. Some paints are really, really reactive, especially the thinner paints. I find they're really reactive. And as soon as you put any heat on them, you just get huge amount of cells coming up, and you guys know I don't like that. I like my cells to be individual, look as if they're kind of floating in space. I think that's why I like the global, because I get that type of cell that I want. Torching across the middle here into that limey green. Not much happening under that red. That's gonna have to let that go, I think, some of that red. It's just not reacting all that well under that red. This half, two-thirds, is gorgeous. It's just that top bit. I don't know how to stop that from happening. Well, let's get some of this off first then. Because this is really pretty down here, so let's get rid of some of that first. And that'll stretch out these little gorgeous cells here. Look at that blending. Oh, it's so pretty. So I'm going to lose all that there by the looks of it. Pretty much all of that. Just help it along a bit. Off you go. Oh, look, now I've got a white stripe on that corner. That's not going to do. Off you go, white stripe. That was just not good. Let's clean that off a little bit so we can see where the end of the card is. Look at those colours, you guys. Oh my gosh. Now the red looks pretty up here. Maybe I'll torch a bit more in the red now that I've stretched it out a little bit. So by torching sort of halfway through your stretching, you'll get different size cells. You'll get bigger cells, obviously, because I've stretched it initially, and then the cells that come up now, they will stay a little bit smaller. Look at them. Look at those little guys. Oh, you're so cute as you are. All right, off to the next corner. Let's see if maybe I can keep some of this from falling off just yet. No, don't like that red there. Do I want any of the red? No, I don't think so. Oh, I hope I've got enough paint now to stick to the other side. Just leave that little band of red there. I can live with that little bit of red there, that's okay. All right, now where to? Hope I'm not going to overstretch it now, because I've tipped off a lot of paint. Now you can see the weight of the paint's there, that bit's moving there. The rest of it's not really moving, so, which is a good thing. Your paint's nice thickness if it's not moving very much up here. You just want it to move here. Let's catch some of this. I'm losing a bit of sellage because the paint's rolling over itself, which does happen, can't be helped. I'm going to tip that back before I let go of the stick, otherwise all the paint's going to just fall off the edge. The problem with the stick, I guess, is you push the paint up and then push it back, so you get these elongated cells. I'll cover the whole thing first and then I may be able to tip some of that off, we'll see. Just bringing the weight of the paint back to the middle a little bit, and then I can change directions and head for that last corner. Just want a few little cells in this green section here. It's kind of a limey green here, which I thought would happen because I had the green and the yellow next to each other. Just want to see if I can get some little cells popping up in that area. See, that looks better. So it was a lot of lime there. Now I've torched, I've got some blue cells popping up under there, which is pretty. I don't know if I'll be able to get rid of that blob. We'll see. See what happens. Move the paint down to where you want it. It's there. Change directions. Take all that weight of the paint down there. And you can see up here it's not moving. Get rid of that blob. I don't want to lose all my pretty cells off the corner though. There we go. Done. Bring the weight of the paint back to the middle. Okay. Let's wipe that off. How's it looking conformation wise? It's so pretty. Now the lime and the yellow together. Now let me have a look. Yellow is transparent and lime is semi-transparent. Maybe the yellow and the transparent color should be next to an opaque rather than a semi-transparent. I think I had them like this, didn't I? I had green, yellow, red. These two are semi-transparent and this one's a transparent. So I haven't got beautiful ringed cells. I think if I put this in between a semi-transparent and an opaque, probably would have got a better effect. It's just because they're too similar, the opacities, they're too similar. That's why I'm not getting the rings around those. I don't think I'll, I was going to try and get some of that off, but I actually don't mind the yellow there. fussy woman? Leave it alone. What do you think? Woohoo! Cells are beautiful and round. Got some little ones through there. Got some bigger ones as well. Let's see if there's anything else that wants to come out and play. Under that red maybe? No. Oh, there's a few coming out under the yellow there. Let's see if I get anything coming up under this green. Not really. Few little red ones popping up here through the yellow. Righto. Well, there's a marked difference, obviously, between the global and the Eraldo. Let me grab this one for you. So, global, Eraldo. Global, Eraldo. And as I said, it's not, I'm not complaining about the paint. It's just that paint doesn't work with my pouring medium. It's taken me over 2 years to develop this pouring medium with this brand of paint. So that's what I love, that's what I use. But, you know, every now and then you want to try different paints, see if there's anything better out there that's going to work, but not so far. So yeah, I'm happy. I'll stick with my global. But as I said, you guys find a paint and a pouring medium that works for you. Get the consistency right and stick with it. This just costs you way too much to experiment constantly. Yeah, find something, stick with it. Righto, let's take you down for a close up. I'm gonna have to work out how I can flip my cup so I don't get that weird pattern at the beginning. It's just odd. Okay, now some really pretty cells. Look at the blue with that yellow. I don't know if you can see it that closely, but the blue cells have got yellow around them, and then they've got orange around the edge of those. So yeah, really pretty. These little tiny ones that have popped up afterwards. Those are nice too. I like the difference in sizes. We've got some pretty blending, haven't we? Got some oranges into turquoise, into greens, into yellows, and down into the reds. So as I said, not that keen on that top right corner there with the yellow and the green together. Must remember not to put a transparent next to a semi-transparent, but if I put it next to the blue, then it would have been totally different again. These are pretty. Look at those. Getting some turquoise. Turquoise and orange and pink in there. So pretty. So yeah, there we go. Happy with that. So you can do primaries. You just have to be a bit careful on how you layer them. And if you mix this too thin, yeah, you'll just get mud. So your mix has to be thick enough that the colors aren't going to blend too much in the cup and on the surface. So just be aware of that. Make your paints nice and thick, and they shouldn't blend so much. All right, thanks for watching. Hope you've enjoyed that. And I know you guys can't get global overseas, but you know, you'll find you've got some beautiful, beautiful paints overseas that I wish I could get. You know, Amsterdam and your PBO and things like that. So, and your Liquitex Basics, which we can get, but they're very expensive here. So, yeah, find something you love, practice it, stick to it. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you for the next one. Bye for now.